Students, welcome back to our channel. Today also we'll discuss some more questions of Government Degree College Lecturers Recruitment Test 2020 conducted by APPSC. First question: A subring S of a ring R has the following axioms. A. S is closed under addition and multiplication. Option B. S is closed under addition only. Option C. S is closed under multiplication only. Option D, S is closed under addition and multiplication, and S is a ring under these two operations. Option D is correct. That subring must satisfy all the properties of the ring, then only it becomes subring. That subset must satisfy all the properties of the ring. S itself is a ring. Option D is correct. Second question. Let phi maps from G to G dash be a homomorphism of group such that kernel phi is equal to identity element, contains identity element alone. Then phi is 1, 1, phi is onto, phi is 1, 1 and onto, and phi is isomorphism. Phi is 1, 1. Option A is correct. Third question. Let Z denotes the set of integers. Then, which of the following binary operation Z gives a group? Option A, A star B equal to A minus B. Option B, A star B equal to A plus B plus 1. Option C, A star B equal to A by B. Option D, A star B equal to A plus B minus AB. Option B is correct. Using this binary operation, we can prove this set of integers is a group. So, option B is correct. Fourth question. If A and A square are both the generators of a cyclic group of order n, then option A, n must be odd, option B, n must be even, option C, n must be prime, option D, n must not be a prime, n must be odd. Option A is correct. For example, we take a cyclic group 1 omega omega square, complex cube roots of unity. In this cyclic group, omega and omega square both are the generators, and order of this cyclic group is 3, so which is an odd number. So simply we can take this example. When A and A square both are the generators, here omega and omega square both are the generators of this cyclic group, and order of this cyclic group is 3, which is an odd. Next, we'll take fifth question. In a permutation group A equal to 1 3 2 1 3 4 4 2 and B equal to 1 2 2 3 3 1 4 4, which of the following is correct? Option A, AB equal to BA. Option B, AB not equal to BA. Option C, AB equal to 5. Option D, AB equal to A square. First we find out A into B. 1 3 here ends with 3 and this starts with 3, therefore 1 1, 2 1, 1 2, 2 2, 3 4, 4 4, 3 4, 4 2, 2 3, 4 3. This is AB, whereas BA 1 2, 2 1, 1 1, 2 3, 3 4, 2 4, 3 1, 1 3, 3 3, 4 4, 4 2, 4 2. Clearly, AB is not equal to BA. Here 2 2, here 2 4, 3 4, 3 3, 4 3, 4 2. Clearly, AB is not equal to BA. Therefore, option B is correct. Sixth question. If F is equal to 2, 3, G is equal to 4, 5, or two permutations on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then GF, G into F is option A, 1, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 4, 5, 5, 4. Option B, 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4. Option C, 1, 1, 2, 3, 3, 5, 4, 2, 5, 4. Option D, 1, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 4, 4, 5, 5. Given G is equal to 4, 5. Therefore, the remaining elements 1, 2, 3 maps to themselves. So, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4. 4, 5, 5, 4. Now, F. 2 image is 3 and 3 image is 2. 2, 3, 3, 2. Whereas the remaining elements 1, 4, 5, they maps to themselves. 1, 1, 4, 4, 5, 5. Now we multiply G and F. 1, 1, 1, 1. 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 3. 3, 3, 3, 2, 3, 2. 4, 5, 5, 5, 4, 5. 5, 4, 4, 4, 5, 4. Therefore, GF is matching to A. Option A is correct. Seventh question. Let G be a finite group of order N. Let A belongs to G and C of A is the conjugate classes of A. Then, which of the following is true? Option A. Order of CA equal to order of G. Option B. Order of CA equal to order of N of A. Option C, order of CA is equal to order of G by order of NA. Option D, order of G. Option C is correct. Order of CA equal to order of G by order of NA. Eighth question. A metric space E, D is said to be complete. A metric space is complete if every Cauchy sequence in that metric space is convergent. Option B is correct. Given options are A, divergent, B, convergent, C, oscillatory, D, absolute. So that metric space is said to be complete if every Cauchy sequence is convergent. Option B is correct. Next, coming to ninth question. Every convergent sequence of metric space is option A, Cauchy sequence, option B, Bayes sequence, option C, conditionally convergent sequence, option D, uniform convergent sequence. Option A is correct. Every convergent sequence of a metric space is Cauchy sequence. Tenth question. A bounded infinite set of real numbers has at least option A, one limit point, option B, zero limit point, option C, infinite limit point, option D, two limit points. By Bolzano-Riesz-Ross theorem, every bounded infinite set of real numbers has at least one limit point. So option A is correct. 11th one. If f is Riemann integrable over closed interval a comma b and also f possesses a primitive f capital F over closed a b, then integral a to b f of x dx is equal to dash option a f of b minus f of a, option b f of a minus f of b, option c f of b by f of a, option d f of b plus f of a. First option is correct. By fundamental theorem of integral calculus, integral a to b f of x dx, we write this small f of x as capital F of f dash x. Since small f possesses primitive, so we replace the small f of x by capital F dash x. Anyhow, derivative and integral gets cancelled. Upper limit minus lower limit applying f of b minus f of a. Of course, constant will cancel. So f of b minus f of a by fundamental theorem of integral calculus, option A is correct. 12th question. If f is bounded function over a closed and bounded interval, closed interval a comma b, then option A, lower Riemann integral is equal to upper Riemann integral. Option B, lower Riemann integral is greater than or equal to upper Riemann integral. Option C, lower Riemann integral is less than or equal to upper Riemann integral. Option D, lower Riemann integral is greater than upper Riemann integral. Option C is correct. Lower Riemann integral is always less than or equal to upper Riemann integral. 13th question. Every bounded closed interval on real line R is A, trivial, B, compact, C, not compact, D, connectedness. So option B is correct. Option B is correct. Every closed bounded interval on real number line, real line R is compact. Option B is correct. 14th question. In a sequence xn, x1 equal to 1 and xn equal to root of 2 plus xn minus 1 is convergent. It is given this sequence is convergent sequence. Then the sequence converges to A1, B2, C minus 1, D0. We'll see now. It is given this sequence is a convergent sequence and obviously this is monotonically increasing and bounded above. Since it is a convergent sequence, monotonically increasing and bounded above is a convergent sequence. So let us consider limit n tends to infinity xn equal to L. Therefore, limit n tends to infinity xn minus 1 is also equal to L. Now, applying limit n tends to infinity on both sides. Limit n tends to infinity xn is equal to limit n tends to infinity root of 2 plus xn minus 1. This is equal to L and this is equal to root of 2 plus L, squaring on both sides. So, L square equal to 2 plus L. L square minus L minus 2 equal to 0. 1 into 2, 2. So, L square minus 2L plus L minus 2 equal to 0. L common L minus 2. 1 common L minus 2. Again, L minus 2 into L plus 1. So, therefore, the limits are 2 and minus 1. Since it is monotonically increasing and bounded above, and also each and every term is positive, therefore L is equal to 2 is the correct answer. Option B is correct. That sequence converges to 2. 15th question. The sequence fn defined by fn of x is equal to nx into e power minus nx square is non-uniform convergence at a point a 0, b e, c x on the close interval 0, 1 and d is 1. Correct answer is a. We will see the proof now. Fn of x is equal to nx into e power minus nx square. We write this as nx by e power nx square. Therefore, f of x is equal to limit n tends to infinity fn of x. Limit n tends to infinity, we replace fn of x by nx by e power nx square. On directly substituting n tends to infinity, we are getting infinity by infinity. So, by using L'Hospital's rule, limit n tends to infinity, differentiating numerator and denominator with respect to n. Nx derivative is x, derivative of n is 1. E power nx square derivative is e power nx square into x square. Now, we apply n tends to infinity, x by infinity gives 0. E power infinity is e infinity. So, x by infinity is 0. Therefore, f of x is 0. Therefore, mn, we are using mn test. Mn is equal to supremum of modulus of fn of x minus f of x for x belongs to R. Supremum of modulus of fn of x is nx into e power minus nx square minus f of x is 0 for x belongs to R. Now we put x is equal to 1 by root n. N into 1 by root n e power minus n into 1 by root n whole square. So, cancel this root n times root n into e power minus n into 1 by n. N also gets cancelled. This gives root n by e power minus 1. So, root n by e. This tends to infinity as n tends to infinity. Therefore, mn does not converges to 0 as n tends to infinity. Therefore, by MN test, this sequence fn of x is a non-uniformly convergent. In the question itself, it is given, this sequence is non-uniformly convergent. But at which point we have to find? As n tends to infinity, one by root n tends to 0. That means x is tending to 0. Therefore, 0 is the point of non-uniform convergence. Option A is correct. 0 is the point of non-uniform convergence. So, these questions may help to many students who are preparing for JL, DL and SET, NET and also competitive exams, entrance exams. These questions may help those students. Hope you understood this class. Thank you.